War is a science which a general must use, with stratagems and strategies, statistical analyses, to know how many soldiers he's prepared to lose. Now, gentlemen, this is the plan for tomorrow's skirmish. The army of the enemy is stationed on the hill, so we've got to draw them down here where they're easier to kill. So you in the ravine, that's the area in green, will move across the plain where you plainly can be seen. Then the enemy in blue will undoubtedly pursue, and will hope to keep your losses to comparatively few. And then... And gentlemen,
and then the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Hark, the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilations, we can hear a great fall nation's cheers.
Pippin, sit down immediately. Now, where was I? Yes. A general accepts that war is hell or even worse. He must never be too cautious or casualty averse. I'm certain the majority of blood that you will spatter will be there through just a minimum of damage that's collateral. But winner for success, we must always pay a price. That's why for my success, you must sacrifice. And then...
And then...
And then...
And then the men go marching out into the fray.
Sorry, Father.
Well, now time is short. I'll have to speed the whole damn thing up. Listen to me, men, as I endeavor to explain what separates a charlatan from a Charlemagne. A rule known to gender was illustrious and various. The pompous is a Pompey, a daring is a Darius. A little rule that every leader knows by heart. It's smarter to be lucky than it's lucky to be smart. And then,
and then,
and gentlemen, and then. Now, Pippin, now!
And then the men and all the marching out into the fray.